I'm Tiffany with the review, and this is a Pacific X-Force Pro. This X-Force Pro features a no-tolerance technology, meaning the weight and balance of each of these rackets should be the same. It weighs 11.9 ounces, has an 8-point headlight balance, 98 square inch head size with 16 by 20 string pattern. It is a standard length racket. Let's go ahead and check in with our playtesters to see what they thought. First up today is Gran. So Gran, what are your thoughts on the Pro version of the X-Force?
Well, once again, I can feel the heritage of these frames. It's got the scalpel feel. Mm-hmm. The dampening is such that I felt like I was getting a little less power than I'm accustomed to. Mm-hmm. Certainly on the ground strokes, my balls were landing a little short. So I had to consciously make some adjustments in the game, get some depth. And targeting was spot on again, the scalpel factor is there. I did suffer a little bit more on the power, on the serve, mm-hmm. but at the volleys, it's just better. And ground strokes, once I dialed in, I liked it very much. So. Overall, two new nice introductions for Pacific. I'm very impressed.
So Jay, what are your thoughts on the X-Force Pro?
You know, with X-Force, what I loved about it was the maneuverability. But with the X-Force Pro, what I loved about it was the plow through and the control I had. I thought with the X-Force, I was able to hit winners because of the angles I was able to hit and pull my opponents off court. But conversely with this one, I felt like I was able to hit down the line winners and clear out winners because mm-hmm. of the extra added power. But you know, I thought for the Pro, it really rewarded timing and preparation. And so if I was able to do that, then it was a great racket. Otherwise, mm-hmm. I felt it was a little sluggish for me. Even though the swing weight is really not that high, it just felt like it in that hand, especially on my backhand. But you know, I thought it was a really, really comfortable racket, mm-hmm. very soft feeling. And you know, something that's probably better for the more advanced players with better technique. But you know, pretty good racket.
And what about strings?
Strings, same thing. Co-poly, full co-poly setup.
And here we are with our last playtester for today, Danny. So Danny, thoughts on the X-Force Pro?
Tiff, you know, I guess the first thing I want to mention is the feel. Right off the bat with both models, it just felt really, really solid. So having said that, this heavier version was better for me. You know, I got more power. I got the added spin, and really between this version and the lighter version, I didn't really feel any differences except for weight, which weight has a big influence on how the racket works out for you. Mm-hmm. So for me, I mean, this is a much better fit from baseline, better fit for me at net, and especially on the serve, I was able to just get a little more pop. But again, I mean, this was a fun racket to play. Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna switch to it. I still enjoy my vocal racket, right. But I think this is a very good racket for people to try out and to test, and especially if you're looking for a racket that's good for your arm. Mm-hmm. Again, very flexible, nice, and just solid overall.
All right, and you liked TCS and the X-Force.
Yeah. Same thing with this one. I'm a big fan of TCS, and we strung out mid-range. Not that this racket needs any more flexibility to it, because TCS has a really, really soft feel to it, mm-hmm. but that's what I used and I loved it.
Well, it sounds like our playtesters are really enjoying the added power they were getting from this X-Force Pro versus the X-Force, and found it to be a very arm-friendly offering. But that's just what we had to say about the racket, and recommend that you take this one out for a demo for yourself. And that wraps it up for this edition of The Review. Thanks for watching.